When the dollar goes down, that means that other currencies, by definition, are going up against the dollar, right? And so as Americans are losing purchasing power, other people are gaining the purchasing power that we lost. So the world is still going to continue to produce goods. It's just that instead of Americans consuming those goods, non-Americans will consume them, because for them, the prices will be going down. For Americans, the prices will be going up. And the same thing with assets. Assets in America, stocks, real estate, will be marked down. But assets in other countries in relation to our assets will be marked up, right? America is going to become poorer as a nation. Other countries are going to become richer. And in fact, America has been a major burden that the global economy has had to bear, because we're, you know, 300 plus million Americans, we're not pulling our weight, right? The world has had to carry our water. They've had to produce the stuff that we consume and save the money that we borrow. That means they've had less to consume themselves, and they've had less savings to invest in their own economies, because they've been investing in ours or loaning to us. So when the dollar crashes and people are no longer hoarding dollars in treasuries, you know, the global economy could really improve. Certain countries will really benefit from that burden being lifted from its shoulders. So in answer to your question, what I'm doing myself and what I'm encouraging my clients to do is I want to invest in countries that have the most to gain from America's loss.
Wow.
I want to own currencies that have the most upside potential against the dollar. I want to own assets and businesses that are going to benefit from wealthier non-American customers having increased purchasing power. Right? Just like at one point, America was a young country and a relatively poor country. And over the course of the 19th century and early 20th century, we became very rich. If you invested in America, 1860, 1870, you made a lot of money as we rose to become this major power. I want to invest in countries that are going to see a large increase in their relative wealth. If you want to construct a portfolio that will do well in, if what I'm saying comes to pass, right? We have stagflation in the U.S., weak dollar, dollar loses its reserve status. You know, we go through this. My portfolios will do extremely well. You know, if you look at the last decade that was similar to what we're going to experience, but this is going to be worse, it was the 1970s. And when the 1970s started, an ounce of gold was $35. By the time it ended, it was $850, right? Oil was $3 a barrel. It went to
$30. Wow.
In 1970, you could buy 4 German marks for the dollar. By the end of the decade, maybe 1.5. The Swiss franc was about 23 cents, in beginning of the 70s. It got up to 80 cents by the end. So all these currencies went up. The Japanese yen, you used to get 360 yen to the dollar in 1970. Now you don't even get 100, but I think it got to maybe 130, 140, 150 in 1980, but huge drop. If people invested in commodities, in foreign stocks during the decade of the 70s, they made a lot of money. If they stayed in U.S. stocks, they lost money. If they stayed in U.S. bonds, they lost even more money, right? So I think what we're going to experience in this decade is going to be far worse financially than the 1970s for Americans who remain invested in dollar-denominated assets. But if you get out of the dollar and invest internationally, like what I'm doing, get into foreign stocks, get into commodities, I think you'll make even more money in this decade than the Americans made who did that in the 70s. Because if you understood the 60s, the problems in the 1970s had their roots in all the money we printed in the 1960s to fund big government, to fund deficits, the war on poverty, great society programs, the Vietnam War, going to the moon. The government started spending a lot of money, started running deficits, the Fed printed money, and then the 70s, and then we kept printing it. It wasn't until Volcker came in with, in the 80s that we actually tightened up monetary policy The problem is we can't do that now because we have so much more debt now than we had then, and it's financed with short-term paper. We don't have the ability to swallow the bitter-tasting medicine that we swallowed then, because this time it would kill us. We'd actually die from the medicine. It would be like a toxin. So there's nothing we could do. So if you understand that the inflation that's been created in the prior decade and that we're still creating is worse than anything from the 60s or 70s. And what happened was in 1971, we went off the gold standard, and that's what really accelerated it. Well, this time the world's going to go off the dollar standard, and that's going to be even worse for the dollar than going off the gold standard was. And so people need to act now, you know, because you can't be too late. I mean, you know, you're going to have to be early.